Hi, I'm Loredana Hager, and welcome to my kitchen. I'm very excited today to share this dish with you. It's called Vitello alla Parmigiana, or in English, Veal Parmesan, as some people pronounce it. This is a dish that my mom has made over the years, and I've always enjoyed it very much. When I moved to the States, I found it difficult to find veal. It's also a very expensive cut of meat. So I've learned to substitute it with pork, and particularly porkloin or boneless pork chops that are cut thinly. If you find a porkloin or pork chops that are pretty thick, like about an inch, you want to make sure that you've pounded to about a quarter of an inch. You want the meat to be fairly thin. Veal, of course, is much more tender meat, so you want to be careful with pounding veal. Of course, if you're fortunate enough to have a butcher that can slice it for you, then ask for very thin cuts. Here I have the pork chops, boneless pork chops, that I purchased. They were about an inch thick, but I did pound them to about a quarter inch, as you can see. So the shades are a little bit odd, but that's okay. We'll be breading this meat, frying it, and then putting it together. So the other ingredients that you will need to do that will be flour, right here, and then some plain breadcrumbs. And to that, I will be adding some salt and pepper just to give it some flavor, and you'll need about a couple of eggs. Then, in order to add the other ingredients that make this dish very, very delicious, is mozzarella. I have fresh mozzarella here that I have drained and patted dry. You want to make sure that there is not a whole lot of moisture. And actually, you want to do the same thing with the meat. You want it to be dry. And then the other ingredient that's also key in this recipe is ham. This is cooked ham versus cured ham. And so it is also fairly thin in slice, the way it's sliced, and you want it that way. You don't want it too thick. And last but not least, I have some tomato sauce. This is meat-based sauce. It's much more robust in flavor. It really adds a richness to this recipe. And if you're interested in knowing how to make meat-based sauce, you can check my YouTube channel where I show you how to make this. It's quite a bit here. I probably will not use it all, but I always like to have enough on hand just in case. So the meat that I'm using today, it's about a pound of pork chops that I've pounded, as I mentioned. I have about 10 to 12 ounces of sliced fresh mozzarella and about 3 ounces of the thinly sliced cooked ham. The bread, the breadcrumbs and the flour and the tomato sauce, really, you're going to have to eyeball that depending on the amount of meat or how thinly you pound it that it will require in order to bread it. I will use 2 eggs, but again, if you're using more or less meat for this recipe, you can gauge whether you need to add an extra egg for this recipe. So I will go ahead and show you the first step and how to bread it and how to put it together. You can see that I've started breading the pork cutlets. I have 2 already completed. I'll show you the process. I've added a pinch of salt, about 1/8 of a teaspoon of salt in the 2 eggs that I've gently beaten. In the flour, I've added about 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper and about another 1/8 teaspoon of salt, just to give it a little more flavor. And of course, the breadcrumbs, these are the plain breadcrumbs. There is no additional flavor spices added to it, so that's important. So the process is you put it first in flour, then in the egg, and then in the breadcrumbs. The reason you do this is the combination of the flour and the eggs help the breadcrumbs bind to the meat. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to continue doing this. When you're flouring the meat, before you put it in the egg, you want to make sure that all the excess flour is off. And I'm going to use this because otherwise it gets very messy. So you want to make sure again that it's just coated, but let the excess egg drip off. And then when you put it in the bowl here with the breadcrumbs, make sure that you press down so the breadcrumbs stick to it. Having a deep bowl like this with plenty of breadcrumbs really helps coat it evenly. Make sure that it's all covered. And again, just like with the flour, when you're done, remove the excess. So once I'm finished breading all these cutlets, they're gonna go in the fridge for about 20 to 30 minutes. The reason you're doing this as well is to make sure that the breadcrumbs bind to the meat before we fry it. As you can see, I've already fried several of the cutlets. I've placed a couple of paper towels just to absorb the excess oil. So I'm gonna be continuing frying the remainder. The temperature here is about medium high. You want to always make sure that it stays at that temperature, especially as you're adding more meat, the temperature will lower. So you wanna make sure that it fries. And you want to keep these cutlets in there for about 3 minutes before you turn them over. As you saw there on the plate, the ones that I've already completed, they're a nice golden brown. I'm using canola oil, but you can choose to use any other type of vegetable oil. Do not use olive oil for the frying part. So I'm going to leave this in here for about 3 minutes, and then I'll check and flip them over and cook them for another 3 minutes. I just want to share something that I thought about earlier when I was showing you all the ingredients that are involved in this recipe. Believe it or not, even though it's called Vitello alla Parmigiana, there is no Parmesan cheese in this recipe. There's mozzarella cheese, which made me think that, you know, as recipes pass on from generation to generation, from family recipe to somebody else, sometimes these get there are variations and changes are made. And again, this is a recipe within my family. As long as I've known my mom making this, there's never been Parmesan cheese that has been added. So it's interesting how recipes evolve even within a generation and being handed down from one family member to another. So I did say 3 minutes, not quite ready. As you can see, I'm gonna leave it another 30 seconds to a minute before I flip it over. This is why it's important to have, whether using veal or pork, that the cutlets are thin. You don't want them to be too thick, otherwise they will not cook through and they will absorb a lot of oil. You wanna make sure that the meat is cooked. So I'm gonna turn it. That one is nice and brown. And this one too. I have a gas stove. If you're using an electric stove, of course, again, the temperature may vary. You know your stove when you're frying things, how to maintain a consistent temperature. And again, you want it to be medium high. While I was frying the pork cutlets, I preheated the oven and it's now ready. It's set at 375. So here I have the pork cutlets. They've all been fried. They cooled off. You want to make sure that they are a little cool, not piping hot, before you assemble it together. So I'm using this particular dish, so anything that will go in the oven, you are not gonna be leaving it in there for too long, just enough for the mozzarella to melt and some of the sauce just to reduce a little bit. I have quite a bit of sauce here, but you'll see I'm just gonna cover each slice of meat so it's not going to be floating in it. So I'll show you how I do this. So I'll take the cutlets. Again, depending on how many slices and the shape, you see some are quite odd because I've pounded the meat as it was pretty thick. So they turned out kind of odd shapes, but that's okay. As long as they all fit and they're not overlapping each other, because you want to put a piece of ham and mozzarella on each individual piece so that each person gets a bite of every ingredient. So just it's like a jigsaw puzzle. Looks perfect there. So you lay that. I just lightly oiled the surface of this dish just to make sure that it doesn't quite stick as it bubbles and the mozzarella melts. So what I'm going to do, for example, this one is quite big.
So I need to do that. And the pieces that are smaller, I might just cut that to size. Now, if this were an ideal, perfect world, each of these pork cutlets would be perfectly round so that the ham would fit perfectly right on top. But we're not in a perfect world, so it's okay. It's going to be covered with the mozzarella and with the sauce, so it doesn't really matter. You just want to make sure, as I mentioned before, that every piece has some ham and some mozzarella and sauce when they take a bite. So I'm going to cover this piece here. And put a little more to cover that piece there. And a little more there. I think we're good. All right, so as you can see, I didn't use all the ham, and that's fine. Now the next step is to add the mozzarella. Now this mozzarella, fresh mozzarella, as I said, I drained it. It's still oozing a little bit of water, and that's okay. I may actually pat it dry. A little more so that I'm not adding any excess moisture to the dish. Now, because it's pre-cut, the thickness is already predetermined. If you want it thinner, you could try slicing it if you have a block of mozzarella. Again, I like using fresh mozzarella rather than just the regular dry block mozzarella, but you can choose. So we're gonna put I'm going to put a piece there, and then we'll see how it goes. You could try shredding it, but as I said, the original recipe, how I was taught, would be a whole slice that you put right on top. Again, a lot of it will be dependent on the size of your meat, as you can see. Some will fit perfectly. Some might be a little bit too small or too big for the mozzarella. So I'm just going to go along and eyeball it and see where it goes. Now this one is the biggest of them all, so I think it will take about 2.5 slices there to cover it so that it nicely melts. There, perfect, it's beautiful. Okay, so the last part is adding the tomato sauce. Now, as I mentioned, you don't want it to, it doesn't have to be totally covered, each piece. You don't want it to be overflowing. This is not pasta sauce, it's not even lasagna. You just want enough to cover each. So I'm using a ladle, and as I said, I've got plenty of sauce here, so I don't have to be stingy, but I also don't want to overdo it. Empty. I probably was a little extra generous. So this is ready then to go in the oven. You'll know when it's ready when the mozzarella that's underneath the sauce will start to melt and ooze underneath. And that's when you know it's time to take it out. You don't want to leave it too long, otherwise the ham will get too dry and so will the meat. This beauty is ready to go in the oven. Pork cutlets were in the oven for about 15-16 minutes. Of course, a lot will depend on the type of oven that you have, that you may have to leave it in there either a little less or a little longer. What you want, and I'm showing here on my plate here, I've put a pork cutlet that I'm about to eat. But you want to see that the mozzarella, as I said, is melted right over. The ham is underneath it. And so you don't want it to over dry it and cook it too long. You don't want to brown the mozzarella or the meat any further. You just want all the flavors to come together.
So we're gonna have a taste test. I'm gonna cut a piece and make sure that in that bite I have some of the mozzarella, the ham is right there, and of course the meat. Here it goes. Delicioso. The meat is very tender and melts in your mouth. There is that salty taste of the ham and then the sweetness from the homemade meat-based sauce that I made. And of course, the mozzarella adds that creamy texture to it. This is just wonderful as a main dish that at any time of the week or for a special occasion for dinner. It prepares really well. You could do some of it ahead of time and then just warm it up if you have some guests coming over. So give it a try, let me know how it goes. Buon appetito. I think I'm gonna go for another bite.